गुड मॉर्निंग, वेलकम बैक। टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू द साइटोप्लाज्मिक इनहेरिटेंस। नाउ लेट अस सी द अनदर एग्जांपल ऑफ साइटोप्लाज्मिक इनहेरिटेंस, अदरवाइज कॉल्ड इन्फेक्टिव हेरिडिटी इन पैरामीसिया।
इन्फेक्टिव हेरिडिटी इन पैरामीसिया।
दिस इज अदरवाइज कॉल्ड साइटोप्लाज्मिक इनहेरिटेंस। दिस इज नो इन्फेक्टिव हेरिडिटी पैरामीसिया। यू माइट हैव स्टडीड द फाइकिंडर क्लासिफिकेशंस, राइट? इन फाइकिंडर क्लासिफिकेशंस द फाइव किंगडम्स आर किंगडम मोनीरा, किंगडम प्रोटिस्टा, किंगडम प्लांटे, किंगडम फंगे एंड किंगडम एनिमालिया, राइट? एनी डाउट? एंड इन किंगडम प्रोटिस्टा अगेन डिवाइडेड इनटू सूफ्लाजेलेट्स, अमीबे और सार्कोडाइन्स, स्पोरोसोवेंस एंड नो सीलिएट्स। द पैरामीसियम इज ए कॉमन नो सीलिएट प्रोटिस्ट, usually found in freshwater ponds, no paddy fields, etc., containing bacteria and no too much of decaying organic substances. There you can see this paramecia. It is having 0.3 millimeter in diameter. So if you take a kumbhal, take a hand of water and you look through this water, you can see small white specks moving around this. These white specks are nothing but this paramecium. And this is this protist is popularly known as slipper animalcule. Slipper animalcule, as it resembles the shape of a sole of a slipper. That is why this is called a slipper animalcule. And know the T.M. Sonnibon studied the extra nuclear inheritance of Paramecium aurelia. This infective heredity is due to the presence of or the action of cytoplasmic particles which can self-replicate and get transmitted from one cell generation to another. Right? Could you follow me? This infective particle is found in the cytoplasm and it is the action of cytoplasmic particles, no, which can self-duplicate and get transmitted from one cell generation to another. And this particular paramecium, no, has two strains. One is killer strain, and another one is sensitive strain. Paramecium, there are two strains, killer strains and sensitive strains. And this killer strains, no, killer paramecium releases a toxic substance called paramecin. Which destroys the, you know, the sensitive strains, which kills the sensitive strains. That is why it is called the killer strain. The killer strains have kappa particles in their cytoplasm. They know that ranges from 500 to 1600 in numbers, and the size ranges from 0.2 micron to 0.8 micron, mu in size. You know the size of 1 mu is equal to 1 by 1000 in a millimeter. That much very minute. and also you know, the size is 0.2 micron to 0.8 micron and contains DNA. And these kappa particles contains DNA. And this kappa particle is maintained in the cytoplasm only when a capital K gene is present. And this capital K gene is responsible for the maintenance of these kappa particles in the cytoplasm of elastrines. Maintenance. And this K gene cannot initiate the formation of kappa particles. The K gene cannot initiate the formation of kappa particles. And it is essential for the duplication of kappa particles. Could you follow me? Any doubt in this? Then this is called infective heredity. In infective heredity in paramecium, this was studied by T.M. Sonneborn in 1943. This infective heredity is due to the action of cytoplasmic particles present in the cytoplasm of killer strains, which can duplicate and get transmitted from one cell generation to another. Right? In Paramecium aurelia, there are two strains. One is called killer strain and another one is called sensitive strains. The killer strain releases a toxic substance called paramecin. And this paramecin, toxic substances, destroys the sensitive strains, kill the sensitive strains. And this particular killer strains have kappa particles in their cytoplasm. And these kappa particles, they are ranges from 500 to 1600 in numbers. And the size measures from 0.2 micron to 0.8 micron. And contains DNA. And the kappa particle is maintained in the presence of the gene capital K. Without capital K, these kappa particles cannot duplicate, cannot maintain the cytoplasm. And this K gene cannot initiate the formation of kappa particles, only maintains and duplicates the kappa particles. Could you follow me? Right? Then, and this is, the protist. There is no self-fertilization, only autogamy self-fertilization, and conjugation is there. And then this killer strain, when this killer paramecium with the capital K killer conjugates with the sensitive strain, this is a small k, this is the sensitive strain, and the conjugation takes place in a very few minutes. Only the exchange of genetic material takes place. Only the genetic materials. There is no exchange of cytoplasm. Then this X conjugants with the capital K small k gene with the kappa particles. With the kappa particles, we can put note here, with the kappa particles, and this X conjugants, this X conjugants without kappa particles, that is here also you can see capital K and small k. Here also you can see capital K, small k. And this produces killer, And this, even though capital K gene is there, without the cytoplasmic exchange, this S conjugates, you know, it is sensitive. The conjugation time is very short, less than 3 seconds, or time period is very short, then only the exchange of genetic material takes place. There is no exchange of cytoplasm. If without any cytoplasmic exchange, only genetic exchange takes place, here it produces the S conjugates with the kappa particles, produces killer strains, and without the kappa particles, producing sensitive strains. When autogamy takes place, or self-fertilizer, autogamy means self-fertilization. Autogamy, it produces 50% killer strains. 50%, that means capital K, so 50%, small k, 50%, and here also it produces 50% sensitive strains and 50% sensitive strains here without any kappa particles. Could you follow me? This is only in the case of the conjugation takes place in a very brief time or very short time, but if the conjugation prolongs, then what happens now, if the conjugation prolonged, the time increases, then what happens now, the cytoplasmic exchange also takes place between these capital K killer strains and sensitive strains. When the time increases, then cytoplasmic exchange also takes place. Then after that, what happens now, this X conjugates, this S conjugates, capital K small k here, and this is also killer, and this conjugates also become killer. This conjugates, X conjugates also become killer. See, capital K small k, this also become killer. Is the time prolonged? Then after autogamy, the killer strains produces 50% killer strains, and here also it produces killer strains and sensitive strains in 50% each. So this clearly shows that the capital K gene is responsible for the maintenance of kappa particles inside the cytoplasm. Only the exchange of cytoplasm, sensitive strains become killer strains. So this is the infective heredity in paramecia, otherwise the example for cytoplasmic inheritance. Any doubt in this? I'll tell you once again. In paramecium, usually you can see the conjugation. There are two strains, that is capital K small k, that is a killer strain, conjugates with the sensitive strains small k gene. And if the conjugating time is very short, what happens? Only the exchange of genetic material takes place, right? There is no exchange of cytoplasm. In this case, the X conjugates with the kappa particles produces killer strains, and the X conjugates without the kappa particles produces sensitive strains. Only exchange of genetic material takes place, right? That means the X conjugates become capital K small k. Here also it is a capital K small k. But when this conjugating time is prolonged, what happens? The exchange of cytoplasm also takes place. In the exchange of cytoplasm, what happens? The kappa particles are also enter inside the sensitive strains. Then these sensitive strains become killer strain. Only the exchange of cytoplasm. That is why it is otherwise called cytoplasmic inheritance. And this the exchange of the cytoplasm with the kappa particles, the X conjugates, the sensitive strain becomes killer strains. This also killer strains. After autogamy or self-fertilization, it produces killer strains and sensitive strains in equal proportions. That much about the infective heredity or cytoplasmic inheritance in paramecium is over. Do you follow me? Shall we stop today's class? Thank you very much.